In July of 2005, several prominent Holocaust scholars demanded that the federally funded Roosevelt Museum revise a display caption that they said downplayed FDR's complicity in the slaughter of 6 million Jews. The caption that was in question acknowledged the stains on the American record and mentioned the country's failure to open its borders to refugees fleeing Nazism. But in the sentence that outraged the critics and sparked the uproar, the caption continued, "Yet even Roosevelt's bitterest critics concede that nothing he could have done, including bombing the rails leading to Auschwitz in 1944, would have saved significant numbers from slaughter, let alone dissuaded the Nazis from doing what they were so intent on doing." Now, there is a very significant debate among historians today, and, you know, for the last several years, and there are those who cite numerous steps that could have been taken, such as granting refugees temporary haven, bombing the rails, pressing the British to open Palestine to refugees, and giving broader funding and power to the War Refugee Board. Others point out, other critics and historians point out, the isolationist and anti-Semitic sentiment on the home front prevented Roosevelt from opening America's borders. But the Roosevelt reaction, the library, did take the criticism seriously and undertook to conduct a thorough review of the entire Holocaust exhibit and revised the main text panel. The library also amended the caption that accompanies the Torah, and you can see the picture of the Torah there, to let visitors know, especially our Jewish visitors, that the Torah had been approved for display as a sacred document. And I think one of the things you have to do is to remove a portion of the text in order to display it so it's not a complete Torah. The caption today reads, "Some historians have documented what they consider FDR's efforts to end the slaughter, not the least of which was, of course, to destroy Hitler and Nazism. The War Refugee Board, which Roosevelt established in 1944, is credited with saving at least 200,000 European Jews. Other historians reject this, claiming FDR was indifferent and should have done more to rescue the Jews from extermination." And then it goes on to talk about the backlash in this country, et cetera. But in addition, I think what's interesting, if you look here just to the right of the display, there is a flip book. And in that flip book, the library contains a number of pages and citations and quotes from various other historians and also documents from the collection so that visitors can read through it and see that there's more than one view of looking at history.